What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com and today's SQL tutorial is all about SQL delete and truncate statement. Till so far we have seen three different ways of inserting data into a table, so I thought to wrap the whole how to insert data series with this tutorial. And today in this tutorial we will learn how to delete or remove data from a table using delete and truncate statement. Once again I'll be using the student table which I have used so far in this how to insert data into a table series. And fortunately this student table has few rows in it and we are going to delete them. Let's start today's tutorial with delete DML command. Delete command can be used to delete entire as well as selected rows from a table or views. Let's take a look at the syntax. As it's a delete query, thus it starts with delete keyword followed by from keyword. After that you have to specify the table name from which you want to delete the data, and at the end we have our where clause. Where clause enables you to choose rows from the reference table or view that need to be deleted conditionally. That is, the only those rows that meet the search condition are deleted. If you omit the where clause, all the rows in the table or view are deleted. Let's perform our first query. Say we want to delete the row where StuID is 4. Student with StuID 4 is Batman and we will delete this row. Let's write the query. We are deleting selected rows, thus we have used where clause here with StuID 4 delete condition, as we just want to delete only those records where StuID is 4. Let's execute. One row deleted. Now refresh here. As you can see, the record for student Batman which has StuID 4 is now deleted. Similarly, now say you want to delete all the rows from a table. As we are deleting all the rows from a table, thus we do not need to specify the where clause. Let's execute. Now let's refresh here. Now we don't have any rows in our table, as you can see here. Delete is a DML command and all the data which has been deleted using SQL delete command get stored into a buffer till you roll back or commit. Means if you have deleted something from your table accidentally and you want it back, then you can perform rollback to get back your data. To perform rollback, you can either write rollback and execute, or if you are using SQL developer then press function key F12 or press this rollback button. Let's do it, as we have already deleted all the rows from our table and now we do not have any rows here. Let's perform a rollback. Let's execute. Now let's refresh here. And here is our data. Now let's take a look at the truncate command. Unlike delete, truncate is a DDL command which can be used to delete all the rows from a table. Since where clause is not allowed with truncate command, thus we cannot delete selected rows using truncate. Let's do a query. Say you want to delete all the rows again from student table. As you can see here, we have 4 rows in student table. Now let's write the query. Let me make some space so that you can see what I'm going to do next. I think everything is now perfectly visible. Truncate command has pretty similar syntax. You just need to write truncate table, both are the keywords, followed by the name of table from which you want to delete the data. Before executing this query, mind that we cannot perform a rollback once we truncate. Means rollback is not possible with truncate command and the deletion is permanent. Let's execute. Table student truncated. Now let's refresh here. Once again all the rows are deleted. Let's try to roll back. Now let's execute. Rollback completed. Now let's try to refresh. Nothing happens. Let's try to roll back by pressing this rollback button. Now let's again refresh. Nothing happens. For more in-depth knowledge of the topic as well as the difference between truncate and delete command, you can read my blog. Link is in the description box. Hope you enjoyed watching. Hit the thumbs up and keep me motivated. Moreover, you can comment your feedback and don't forget to subscribe. That's it for today's guys. We'll see you soon. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.